Does anyone want to raise? Oh, yes, the pink one down there.
Hello, Barnaby Collins from DP9. The question I wanted to raise is how you measure a standard of design. When you come to energy efficiency or BREEAM ratings, you have very good, excellent, that ticks box-ticking type measurements. When it comes to good design, one man's castle is another man's eyesore. And I wonder how you can raise the standard. If something is very good design, is the next step excellent, mega, ultimate, platinum? I'm not quite sure how you measure that. Surely the desire should be to get very good design or good design. I'm not quite sure how you move on from that.
Does anyone in the room have any suggestions as to a policy framework that can respond to that?
He's responding.
Julian Robinson, London School of Economics. I think in assessing a planning application, somehow recognition should be given to that if the client's brief aspirations are clearly articulated in terms of getting design quality, and also whether or not they've actually gone through a rigorous design competition to achieve those aspirations. I think also there should be generally a presumption against facade retention except in, say, special policy areas, because you talk about trying to encourage greater architectural creativity. And in response to the question just previously, there clearly has to be some sort of peer review, whether it's CABE design review or Westminster City Council design review, so you're getting the perspective of a number of players within the sort of design and architectural circles.
Guy Bransby, Jones Lang LaSalle. Just coming to the question of how you might address that particular point, I just wonder whether the Supplemental Planning Guidance Design Matters in Westminster, which is 8 years old now, should be reviewed as part of this process. Might be a way to deal with it.
Just technically, we are looking at reviews of those documents, but I think in terms of it, as we say, that BREEAM has things, there's Code for Sustainable Homes, and those things assess sustainability. But does anyone want to put forward a suggestion with relation to something that can be independently audited, something the council can monitor in a technical sense and give feedback through its annual monitoring report, and anything to do with architectural quality?
What about that point of relaxing facade retention?
That's certainly noted.
It's symptomatic, isn't it? You're frightened, so what do you do? Just let's keep what we've got. It's good enough, or it's done in the past, it'll do for the future.
Okay. Mr. Bullock.
Hugh Bullock. I just wanted to quickly touch on the question what we mean by design. Traditionally, it's been looked at first and foremost about appearance, and I think it'd be useful to, in looking at a policy framework, distinguish between environmental quality and architectural quality, and then looking at architectural quality specifically to look at the functionality of buildings, whatever the land use, and that is part of the overall design process. So I think it's worth rethinking what we mean by design. I think that has moved on.
So would you suggest including all elements, the functionality, the architectural appearance, and also the sustainability of it as a whole?
I think all those issues go to good design.
Right.
Chairman of the planning committee when we produced the planning brief for the Chelsea Barracks. Now, this is a very important document, and we produce a number of planning briefs. But very unfortunately, in this instance of the Chelsea Barracks, the architects didn't adhere to the planning brief, which was very detailed in what the requirements were for that site. And it's quite difficult to know how you can get people to actually take note of the publications and the requirements that are currently produced. Now, people, it was said earlier by a gentleman in front about size and getting the maximum out of the land use. Well, for those of us who have known the old Department of the Environment, the Three Sisters, or whatever it was called, in near Horse Ferry Road, and it was completely demolished, as you know, and rebuilt. It's a much better building all round, and it is bigger. So there is no argument in my mind that tall is quite best or tall provides the most accommodation, because on those facts, and it was a very substantial development there, it proved to be the case that, in fact, the height could be substantially lowered, and I think it's 14 floors instead of 40. So I do wish, though, people would adhere to the publications we currently produce. Thank you. Thank you.